I was always called a person with a nonprofit mentality, and I think they were right, I do, because most of the things that I wanted to do did not involve money or making a lot of money. It was just to see some results in the community, things that I could help out with. And I was able to start the Colorado Black Women for Political Action. In that organization, we got more black women on boards and commissions than we ever had before. And it was a statewide, it's still going on. The Black Roundtable, I got that started here, and we're revitalizing that now. And then Leadership Institute that I was told we were talking about. That
you started in 2001?
One, yes, and that was another thing. And then on the national level, the National Organization of Black Women Legislators, I'm their executive director now, and we have a partnership with Rutgers University at COP there, and we also have a National Leadership Institute for Black Women there.
All right.
So I work with that throughout the year, and really busy, but doing things that I thoroughly enjoy doing. I just think that you need women at the table when you make public policy, because if you don't have them there, there are certain things that will never happen. And in order to make good public policy, I think you need the input of everybody, and you just can't just have an all-white male, you know, sitting there doing that. The parental responsibility was important to me, but the marital discrimination, I decided to do that bill because there were several in the Denver Post didn't allow you to be married and work in the same department. I carried the bill, and we were successful with it, and we were real proud of that. I guess one of the others that I'm really proud of is the abandoned baby bill. That was my bill, too, and we've had saved, maybe close to 20 lives now.
So tell me more about that.
Well, that was a bill that if you would take the baby within 72 hours to the fire department or to emergency clinic or something, you didn't have to give any information, just walk away and leave the baby there. And the governor didn't sign it. He let it become law without his signature. In 10 days, it can become law if he doesn't sign it. But he felt that it was saying, I'm going to give up my baby and not be making women not responsible. That's what he said to me. But I think it's turned out real well. And he declared Abandoned Baby Day, Safe Baby Haven or something, he called it day. And I thought, gee, he didn't even sign it. Why is he doing this? But it did. But that was a good bill, I thought, and really made a big difference. I also carried the prostate cancer bill because men, you know, we don't want to be widows. I was a widow when I was in my 40s, and I don't want to see that happen. And believe it or not, it was mostly the men that went to the mic to fight it. We don't need to make any demands on insurances, you know, we got enough, blah, blah. That got through, though, but after 3 times, had to carry it for 3 years. We were able to get, so I've carried other stuff. And depends on how you look at them and how you face them, because if you keep thinking that things are there because I'm a woman and I'm black and I'm this and I'm that, I don't think you'll ever do it. You have to take a positive, and my attitude was that I can do it. I don't care what the obstacles are because my limitations are mine, not yours, you know, and if you want to place them, I'm going to overcome them. So I never really, you know, thought. But if I had thought about that, I'd be sad every day because there's so much discrimination against, still against women and minorities. All the things that I've accomplished that I've wanted to accomplish, I set goals and I've been able to accomplish all of them. I don't believe that obstacles should remain obstacles. I think of them as a challenge that turn them into challenges that this is what I want to accomplish and I want to do it by this time. Like I said, by the time I was 40, I wanted to have my master's, and I did. So I kind of set goals and worked on those goals and found ways to overcome obstacles, you know, so. I just saw the need, and I think the need is still there, and I thought I could help. I like to be involved, and this is something, what I'm doing now, I thoroughly enjoy working with Rutgers and working here with the Leadership Institutes. The main thing of these institutes and things, there's somebody after Rachel Noel, after me, you know, that you keep on running and you don't stop. And I think if that happens, I will feel that everything I tried and put so many hours in made what I wanted it to be. And it would help society and families and everybody else. So I'm real pleased about that.